Welcome to Let's Play Borderlands. I'm sure everybody in the world has already done a Let's Play of this, but kind of want an excuse to play it again, and it's a fun game, and I don't have a lot of first-person shooter style things on the channel, so it seemed like a nice way to add some variety. I lost my train of thought. Congratulations, I've been confused and I haven't even started the game yet. It's gonna... Oh, there we go. Gonna start a new character anyway. And maybe I'll remember what I was trying to say.
So, you want to hear a story, huh? One about treasure hunters. Have I got a story for you, Pandora. This is our home, but make no mistake, this is not a planet of peace and love. They say it's a wasteland, that it's dangerous, that only a fool would search for something of value here.
So it's where all the foxes
then
go?
Perhaps I am a fool, but do not be fooled by what Pandora appears to be. It was a legend. Many people tell it. The legend of the vault.
Why did you name it Vault?
My father would always go on about the vault, even with his dying breath. Advanced alien technology, infinite wealth, fame, power, women. So you can understand why some little kiddos who hear the stories grow up to become vault hunters. Well, I have a story you may not believe, but I tell you it is true. The legend of the vault is real, and it is here on Pandora. And let's call her a guardian angel, appeared to guide the vault hunters to their prize. The tale begins right here, on Pandora, with the brave vault hunters, the guardian angel, and most importantly, me.
Me who? Who me? Who me you? You me who? I'm going to go ahead and keep this on the recording just because. I do feel bad for the poor Skag. Puppy! Your evening will be nice and you can go and send me on my way. I said, you're such a sweet old thing, why you do this to yourself? She looked at me and this is what she said. Oh, there ain't no rest for the wicked. Money don't grow on trees. I got bills to pay, I got mouths to feed. There ain't nothing in this world for free.
All right, back there, time to wake up. It's a beautiful day, full of opportunity.
As himself. He's too cool for a class name, apparently. I feel bad for the poor Skag, though. Even if they do try to eat me.
Next stop, Fyrestone Depot. Time to gather up your stuff. Who's getting off the bus? You, with the sniper rifle and the crazy mask. You look like a Traxican wrestler, moonlighting as a dominatrix, man. And you, soldier man, are those armor pieces from the Crimson Lance you're wearing? And what's your story, young lady? What can you do? Perhaps you can bake us all a wonderful cake? And you, beef stick in the back. I'm not gonna make fun of you. Your burps smell of blood, and you growl like a rabid animal.
Don't mess with Brick.
Anyway, I've got some advice for all of you. It's tough out there, and you won't be able to just beat up on whatever you please until...
He's a chatty one.
Sure, you can take from the bandits or find things in the wild, but equipment you buy from my stores are guaranteed. And if you die, you can't get your money back because you're dead. I kid. No need to be so serious here.
It's my turn now.
And if you're looking for the vault, well, you're going to have your work cut out for you. So don't be afraid to spend what it takes to get the equipment you need. You listen to Marcos. I come from 7 generations of merchants, and I'm the best. Want to know why? Because I'm making it out here, in this place.
It's actually because he had all his competition killed, but, moving on. Okay. And the music starts back up. Gonna go ahead and mute the music for a second. I've been trying to figure out which class to play for the Let's Play. The first time I played the game, I played as Brick. I was co-op with a friend. I have a bad habit of always ending up using sniper rifles, so naturally I lean more towards Mordecai, the hunter. I've played the soldier type before, well, to be honest, in Borderlands 2, and I've never done Lilith before. She's more the... I guess elemental guns and assassination type. I was kind of a coin toss between Lilith and Mordecai. If I ever happen to call him Mordekaiser, please ignore it. I've clearly been playing League of Legends too much. I was coin toss between Lilith and Mordecai, but since I'm planning to try to do a Let's Play of Borderlands 2 after this, and I'd like to do Craig... I'm going to go ahead and do Mordecai, since Lilith would be kind of a melee type if I was going to use her. And since Craig's a melee type too, I'm going to go for variety. I'd really love to use Zero in Borderlands 2, but Craig's one I've not used before, so it would make it more interesting to see me scramble about not having a clue what I'm doing. So, probably going to go ahead and go, oh, I don't have the window selected, and go with Mordecai. But, going to go ahead and unmute the sound, the music's playing still, and get on into the game.
Don't be alarmed. I need you to stay calm and don't let on that anyone is talking to you.
How are you in my eyes?
Start making your way off the bus.
Why are you in my vision?
You don't have any reason to trust me, but I need you to believe that I'm here to guide you. I'm here to help you find the vault. In a moment, you'll be greeted by a funny little robot. Do everything he says. You'll know what I mean when it happens.
How is she communicating with him? I always wondered that. Little Marcus bobblehead down there.
Well, we're here. Don't worry about saying goodbye. I'm sure we'll be doing this all again soon enough. Get off my bus.
Well, aren't you just a basket full of sunshine? Go away. Shoo. Drive away, magic bus. Ah, bright sun. More players equals tougher enemies. Tougher enemies equals better loot. That reminds me of Diablo 2. It even has a similar login message. Like, when a player joins co-op, it reminds me of the message that would pop up in Diablo 2 about the enemies getting stronger.
See you next time! Oof.
Yeah, the recording software has dropped my frame rate slightly.
Fyrestone. I am CL4PTP. You may call me by my locally designated name, Claptrap. Before continuing, please accept this echo communication device and heads-up display, provided free of charge by the Doll Corporation.
Okay, let's see. That's not too bad. I have bullets, but no gun. Delightful. Just carrying 6 bullets in my hand for no good reason.
Great! I detect that your echo device is fully functioning. This way, please.
Okay, if the frame rate happens to become an issue, I'll tinker with that as we go. Come back here, you. You didn't see that. Nobody saw that.
Step right up. This is the new you station. When you use this device, your DNA profile is automatically identified and stored. Please activate the new you station now.
Oh. What is this tweak? Oh, it's his pants. Black pants. Silver. Black. There we go. It works for me. I'm gonna go just leave his name as is, and I think that's fast travel.
Excellent! Now that your DNA is registered, you have the best in horrific death and dismemberment insurance! Should an unfortunate fatal incident occur, your new you will appear at the nearest station.
Fun fact.
Now we can head into the peaceful town of Fyrestone. I'll lead the way.
A fun fact about the new you stations. When you die, it's actually a digi-constructed clone of you that comes back. The new you stations in Borderlands 2 will sometimes remark about the fact that you're technically a clone of yourself. Oh, good gracious, there's cars flying everywhere. Look at the fox to be climbing over random stuff instead of doing anything useful. Oh, is there a button here?
Are they gone? Whew. Those bandits really have it in for us claptraps. Using us as target practice is not part of our programming. And open! Yes!
Wait for the door to open. Dang it.
Feel it!
Can tell my aim is not perfect today. Oh, that's right. There we go. Sniper ammo. More sniper ammo. What are you over there muttering about, Claptrap? Dang. Excuse my horrible aim. There's a couple key shortcuts I'm gonna have to change. I'm used to the middle mouse button being melee attacks.
You really don't want me to come back with 9 toes. Open the door.
That hurt.
Nobody heard that. Somebody shot at me. Oh, hello there.
That was a doozy. You should open this storage device. There may be something inside to help against those bandits.
Switch weapons using the mouse wheel. Ooh, and it's got the exact same scope on it.
That looks like it could do some damage. Okay, let's get this gate open.
I found monies. Population. They whited it out and have to lower the number apparently. Guns this way.
These controls seem to be damaged. Have no fear. I'm sure I can do it. waiting! Quick, this way!
He knows I'm after him. Oh, come on. Come on, my aim is bad today, ain't it? Memory serves, one of the unique things about Borderlands in that it combines some RPG stats is that, where's my inventory? Right there, accuracy 95.7%. That number affects, there's a small, basically the bullets have a cone fire, and depending on how high that number is and whether you're looking through a scope or not, they can be slightly off target. In the case of sniper rifles, they tend to have a very good accuracy, but may not always hit dead on. Mordecai has some skills that will improve that. Well, I have no shield, so great. I mean, that's also useful.
That hurt?
Hold still, you.
Excellent. I knew you were the right choice, friend. Now go. I'll contact you again soon.
Attention, citizen of Fyrestone! There is no cause for alarm! This new visitor has resolved the problem!
Well, shoot, I thought I was a goner that time. Damn bandits won't leave us alone. Had to lock the place up tight. I'll let you in. Come on! Damn it! Blasted circuits are on the fritz again. Give it a go from the switch out there, would you?
A quest that involves
now
opening
a door.
Now
that you've selected a mission, you'll notice that a new icon has appeared on your heads-up display. That's a waypoint. The waypoint will tell you where you need to go, depending on what mission is currently active in your mission log.
I have a bad habit of reloading incessantly when there's not enemies around. And let's meet Dr. Zed. He's using a Psycho's Buzz Axe. That's not a good sign. You worry me, sir.
Thanks for opening her up again. The name's Zed. They don't let me cut on folks anymore since I lost my license, so now I keep the med vendors around here up and running. From the vendors, you can buy all the healing you could ever want from a real doc. Thankfully, without the "fault is a myth, you'll get yourself killed" lecture.
Dr. Zed. Yeah, I have the textures turned down slightly. Well, where do I turn
it? I might not have a med school degree, but when you get shot, you'll be happy I'm here.
I'm over here!
Oh, there we go.
I'm over here!
So, we're past 15-minute point, so I'm going to go ahead and pause it here, and I will see you next time.